welcome to Neutral Site Action, and we're just about ready for kickoff. This coin toss presented by Nissan, innovation that excites. Utah is getting fired up down there as they get ready to boot this opening kickoff. He'll return it from the one. He gets out to about the 22-yard line. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Brought down at about the 25-yard line. Looks to the back and can't connect. Number six. Third down and seven. Ball on their own 25. Got it. Complete. He's out of bounds.
This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
And he tackles him hard at the 42-yard line. Tackled after a decent pickup. He's at the 30. They'll bring him down around the 28-yard line.
You know, Brad, that's the second third down that they've been able to convert on this drive. And this offense right now has really showed a lot of poise and been able to hold on to the football and try to maintain this drive.
From the 28-yard line, it's first down. He's at the 20. Tackle made at about the 11.
They've obviously found the formula for moving the ball against this defense. Let's see if any adjustments are made before their backs are really against the wall.
Tackle at the 11. Run to the outside. Takes a handoff, tackled for a loss.
Did you see how quickly he was able to get into the backfield and make that tackle? Not many guys that big can move that fast.
They're going to go for the easy three here. Oregon is looking to go up by three. Kicks away, and it's through the uprights.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 23-yard line. Utah's coaching staff so confident, they know they've got a guy that's one of the best running backs in the country and that they can just play their game and not worry about the factor on the road.
Well, Brett, his big playability not only can give you big chunks of yards on the road, but more importantly, it can quiet this atmosphere and allow the quarterback in this offense just getting back and just being able to run and be able to communicate. And I think that's a big challenge for this team. So look for his big playability to maybe even out the atmosphere and give this offense a chance to be able to execute.
Junior. gets hit out of bounds.
Right around the 42-yard line. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook.
Backward pass. That's a fumble. Offense falls on it.
From their own 38-yard line. Second down. Almost picked off.
Smart, heady play by that defender. That was solid, fundamental pass defense.
Airing it out long. Oh, he had the pick and he dropped it.
So that'll make it fourth down.
Great hold by the defense. They were expecting the pass play, and they defended it very well.
Gets out to about the 32-yard line. Well, the defense held them to three on their last possession. Pitching a shutout on this drive would be even better. Oregon has a three-point lead. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. And he's tackled at the 35.
Here on third down. It confused the defense just enough to allow him to pick up the first.
Here's a throw. I don't think he got anything on that.
That makes it second and 10.
Gets to about the 47-yard line.
Gain of 3 yards. That makes it 37.
They run left and he'll lose yardage. Holds a field goal lead. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. This offense was infected by the turnover bug their last time out. Let's see if they can hold on to the ball here.
I look for the offense to come out with the same game plan as before. You don't make changes after one play.
That one's incomplete. Both offenses trying to find their rhythm in that first quarter. Low scoring and close right now. Oregon's got a three-point lead. And we welcome you back to the action here, and we have got a tight one going on in quarter number two. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation. It out to his receiver in a hurry. He's tackled around the 37-yard line. Good pitch and catch there on second down.
Yep, it was good enough to get him a first down. That's just a nice play.
Defense goes with the extra defensive backs as the offense comes up five wide. Pass is caught, the defense lays him out.
That'll bring up second and three.
fires out to his receiver. And they make the stop
at about the 47-yard line.
They'll line up with five wide receivers. Got an opening. Makes it to the 41.
Awesome running here on third down. That can bring a lot of confidence to an offense when they can pull that off so successfully.
Got a man, but he's tackled back behind the line of scrimmage. They get a one-yard loss on that one.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
That'll bring up second and 12.
From the 42-yard line, it's second down. They'll spread the field with five wide. He gets rid of this one.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. Completes it, but he can't shake the defense. The defense didn't stop the pass, but they stopped him short of the sticks.
And that's the important thing here. Allow him to make the catch, but make sure you tackle him before he gets to the first down marker.
Defense stiffens there and gives it back to their offense. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Oregon is up by 3. He's scrambling. He's taken down at the 40-yard line. Looking for the corner. Gets out to around the 48. Receiver's got him on the screen, and he's taken down at the 26-yard line. From the 26-yard line, third down. And he is drilled at the 15. Seven.
That makes it second and 2.
Oregon is up a field goal. Touchdown, Ducks. He makes the PAT, an 8-play, 67-yard drive, and they get it in for 7. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. Going deep. And it's picked off. It's the safety.
The defense here comes up with a huge interception. They've already got the lead, and it looked like this offense was trying to get back in the game, but that was a big turnover.
From their own 29-yard line, first down. Gives it to the back, and he hits him hard at the 26.
Well, you can really mess with an offense's game plan if you can take away their ability to run.
Throws complete. He's got room to work. Locked down around the 44-yard line. Second down. And they get him in the backfield for a loss.
Big hit on the quarterback. That's one of those, as an offensive lineman, when the film study starts to come around, you're going to kind of sink in your chair and just hope they don't call you out, because you're going to get embarrassed on Monday on that one.
And down he goes at the 27. The Utes know, I think, that at some point they just have to do what they do, even if it's not working right now. If they can get it going in the second half, it should really improve the ball game in the offense.
Well, the offensive line, I think, also has to be accountable here. We look so much to our star players, and we always want them to put up big numbers. But to me, the two go hand in hand. When a running back's going to have a great game, the offensive line deserves some credit. When a running back's struggling, you got to look at that offensive line and say, fellas, you got to help me out. We're not going to change or deviate from this game plan. We need to be able to change this game around, and it starts up front with the offensive line.
And he just gets rid of it.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Quick throw. They'll get him for a loss. And that was a really well-played series by the defense.
This is the kind of solid, consistent play you look for in your defense. Let's see if the offense can follow it up.
He's tackled at the 50.
I give the defense credit, but right now there's more cases of sloppy offense.
Yeah, you got to recognize that both defenses have come into this game with the right mindset, and they're very well prepared. But I'm with you. It's one thing to have great defense. It's another thing when those defenses are going up against offenses that just are not clicking right now and hitting on all cylinders.
Let's see if this drive has a more rewarding conclusion than their last, which ended with a punt. There's a strike complete. He's down. Complete. He's got space to work. He's knocked out of bounds at the 36. First and 10. Ball on the 36. Scrambling around. And he's sacked. Screen pass. They'll bring him down at about the 23-yard line. He's going to try and scramble. The ball pops free. The defense scoops it. And he's leveled at the 24-yard line. And they couldn't have asked for a better time for the turnover, right, Herbie?
Well, I'm sure they could have used a couple of these earlier in the game, but better late than never.
You know they'd like to do something a little more than they did on their last drive when they had to punt the ball away. Quick strike and he drops it.
Well, that is a big hit by the defense there. Good job of timing up the hit. And he didn't get there too early for the pass interference. He waited till the receiver touched the football, and then he was able to dislodge the ball from the receiver.
Runs outside for a nice gain.
Gain of 4 yards. That'll bring up third and six.
And that'll do it. We head to the break. Still plenty of time left in this one. Oregon's got a 10-point lead.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. That first half did one thing for sure. It ordered up an upset. It started percolating right now. Venti size, dark brood, firm with a little kick at the end. We could have one percolating here.
Oh, yeah. We didn't see it coming, but it definitely looks like this team was ready to rock, and you could see them making plays. And it doesn't seem like it's stopping. It doesn't seem like they stopped the bleeding going into the second half or to the end of the first half. It looks like something that could continue. Tell you what, them boys that were favored, they better start getting ready to play because they got a fight on their hands now.
David's ready to get back on that couch, get the remote, get all the games dialed up to watch what's going on around the country. Time to get you back for your second half. Brad and Kirk, ready to roll.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Ducks continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Tackle at the 37. Fires out to his wide out. Tackle made around the 49-yard line. Just throws this one away.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run it.
Up the middle for a nice game. He's on the run. And they got him.
The protection broke down. The defense was in the backfield in a hurry, and they brought the quarterback down. Nice play.
He'll try to change the field position and especially not get it to the end zone. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. He scrambled. And he's tackled right around the 48-yard line. Scrambling. So it'll be second and 14 after the setback.
This defense is fast enough that they can create negative yards on completed passes. So the offense might want to consider that next time they try that play.
They come out on an empty backfield. Fires it out. He's tackled around the 24-yard line. It's the offense that takes the field on fourth down. Gets out to around the 15. Receiver incomplete. Third down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 16-yard line. Makes a catch, and he's got nowhere to go. Kicks away, and it is good. Morgan is ready to kick it away. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20. Oh, man, he took him down hard.
I just love to watch this defense play. They've been flying all over the field today, making big play after big play. The crazy thing is, we still have such a close game despite how well they've played.
Their last drive resulted in a punt, so let's see if they can put together something a little more promising here.
If they're going to make a comeback in this game, it's going to have to start now. This offense has to get rolling.
Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. And they make the stop at about the 45. So on first down, they go to the air and pick up huge yardage.
Well, that was just a well-executed play. They picked a perfect time to stretch the defense with a passing play, and it worked.
From the 45-yard line, first down. Makes it to the 37. the handoff, left side. Tackled after decent pickup. Here's the halfback, and he carries the ball for a nice game.
Call it a game of 5 yards. That brings him second and five.
He's taken down around the 26-yard line. He did not get to the first down marker. It's fourth down, and they're going to try to go for it. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. And he's taken down at the 10-yard line. Fires quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown.
Need to be aware this aerial attack is capable of making some big plays. They've got to get on their toes.
And he adds the extra point. Through three quarters now, and still the defenses are shining. Oregon's lead is 6. Like they're ready for the kick. He'll return it from the 3. Tackle made at the 28-yard line. Back to the action here. Tight ball game in the fourth quarter.
This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball.
Excellent open field tackle. Gets it out quickly.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
And the defense gives up some free yards to the offense.
You know, penalties can ruin a team's chances to win if they commit too many.
From their own 45-yard line, it's first down. Oregon is up by 6. Complete, and he stopped immediately.
I think he could have taken a risk down the field, but he played it safe instead, and that's one of the keys to winning ball games.
That makes it 7-6.
And now he's got room to run. Makes it out to about the 40.
Some daylight.
He gets out to about the 8.
The offense coordinator right now is very happy with the execution. That's the 5th first down on this drive alone. The big thing is when you have this kind of drive going, you don't want to end it in a field goal. Now you want to focus on trying to put the football into the end zone.
Touchdown, Oregon! So the offense is going to go for 2.
Let's go!
He's scrambling, and they won't get the 2. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. From his own goal line, he's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. They'll take over here, ready to start a new series. They'll spread the field with 5 wide. They'll bring him down at the 35.
There's very good chemistry between these two. They like to run through all their routes before the game. And I have to say, they look sharp before this one even started.
Defense goes with the extra defensive backs as the offense comes up 5 wide. Complete. He's got room. Tackle at the 41-yard line. They spread the field in the gun with 5 wide receivers. Now he tries to buy some time. He's at the 30. Tackle made at the 27. Less than 3 minutes in the game. He's got it with room to run. And he hits him hard at the 19-yard line. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks.
They did everything. They got to the quarterback. In fact, it looked like they had a chance to bring him down for the sack. Somehow, he's able to throw the ball away.
This is the 9th play of this drive. He laterals the ball. Touchdown, Utah! Hits the PAT. A 9-play, 78-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Fred, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
So the score now, 19-14. Utah's plan today was to keep it in his hands. He has come through for him to this point, and now he's got a chance to maybe ice it.
Yep, they're going to try to find a way to get him the football in space. It's going to be up to the defense to have at least 2 defenders near him to prevent that big play. It's going to be exciting to see how this game finishes up.
On the ground, up the middle, and they get nice yardage on that run.
That makes it 7-6.
5 guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. That quickly incomplete. Third down. down now, and they need to get it inside the 41. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. Quick throw. He's hit and taken down. Slings it, and he's shoved out of bounds at the 2.
That makes it first and goal.
It's first and goal, and they need a touchdown. So they'll go for 2 here and try to go up by a field goal. They come out in a 5-wide set. And they get the 2. They line up to kick this one away. It's fielded at the 2. He's tackled at the 27-yard line. Oregon's been unable to really show that they're the team to beat here, but it looks like they're going to get another chance at it.
Well, it's now or never. This team has put themselves in a position where they have to hope for some heroics late. It's because they played sloppy most of the game. They're very fortunate they still have a chance to be able to win this game.
A little over a minute in the game. He makes it to the 28-yard line. Knocked out of bounds around the 30-yard line. From their own 30-yard line, third down. He's going to try and scramble. And he's tackled at the 37. Scrambling around, decides to slide. The Ducks taking their first time out of the half. From their own 42-yard line, second down. Here's the handoff, and he's taken down for a loss.
Did you see how that big defensive line got such a good push on that play? That's exactly why they were able to stop him for a loss.
Stays in bounds and made a nice catch. First and 10. Ball on the 43-yard line. Pulls it in and he's in the open field. And down he goes, around the 27-yard line. He scrambled. And they bring him down for a sack on the play. Under a minute left in the game. And he stops the clock with a spike. So far this drive, the defense has been unable to stop them on third down. He launches one for the end zone. Well, you can see the elation on the defensive coordinator's side of things, and why not? His defense just came up with one of the biggest stops of the game in a vital spot in this fourth quarter. The kick is away, and he nails the long field goal. Oregon lines up for the kickoff. Excellent kick. He's to the 20, and he's tackled at the 24. Late in the fourth quarter now, tie football game, and if we're headed to overtime, I hope it's going to be as good as what we've seen through four quarters. He passes it. This one will fall incomplete. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 24. Swings it out left to the halfback. The Utes will use their first time out of the half. Five, maybe six on that screen pass. They've got one more shot. Let's see if their prayers will be answered with a good old Hail Mary. Well, the player of the game might come from the defense after that stop here late in the fourth quarter. That could be the turning point. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line. That'll do it for regulation, and we are going to settle this one in overtime. Well, we played an hour, and it's still not enough. We're set to kick off here in overtime. So it's second down now. They need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Pitches back. Touchdown, Ducks.
Well, this is what it's all about in college football. I score. Now let's see if you can respond. Great teams always find a way to come through.
Converts the extra point. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 25. And they make the stop around the 15-yard line. Touchdown, Utes. So So they come up with the equalizer.
This offense did just what they had to do. They knew they needed 6 points, and they got it. That was just a great series.
Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. And he tacks on the extra point.
Well, this is why I love the overtime rules in college football. Both teams had a fair shot at it, and they'll get another opportunity to try it again.
From the 25-yard line, first down. Trying to set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback. Knocked out of bounds at about the 11.
That makes it first and 10.
But the defense is fired up, responding and reacting to that sack. Not only do they get the quarterback, but they hit him and hit him hard. I think that can really create some confidence for this defense. The next time this quarterback drops back to throw, you got to be thinking he's going to be a little bit gun-shy and concerned about the pressure that these defense is putting on him.
Second and 15. Ball on the 16. Receiver, touchdown. So they draw first blood here in double overtime.
Avoiding field goals in overtime is just huge. Anytime you can get 6 in overtime instead of 3, you're going to be tough to beat.
He makes the PAT. We've got a first and 10, all on the 25-yard line. Pulls it in and stops in his tracks with that tackle.
Pretty timid play calling right there. Let's see if they decide to open it up a bit more.
That'll make it 35.
From the 20-yard line, third down. He's on the run. And he's going to be sacked.
This quarterback has to do a better job of avoiding the rush because sacks can be real drive killers.
This could be it, fellas. It's fourth down. And this one comes to an end. Our final count in this game, Utah 36, Oregon 29. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.